Morning, buddy. Man, that car is messy from that hunting trip. What's up, dude?
Hey, Dad.
Man, this is messy in here. Whew. Good morning, guys. Steve here. My man, Devin, is driving. Y'all pray for me. He's driving now.
I'm going to do good.
Mason back there. And we are 6 Day Ranch. Beautiful is inside the house. She decided to stay home this morning. We're going to go into Goliad, Texas, and get us a piglet nipple waterer. Yep. Because we want to make sure that those piglets, even though they may not need water right now, it's always a good idea to have fresh water available at any age. At least, I think so. So what we're going to do is we're going to reconfigure the automatic nipple water situation out there. We're going to get a piglet waterer, and we're going to mount it a little bit lower to the ground so that they can reach it. And of course, we don't have one of those. So we're going to go on Goliad. We already called the feed store. They have them. So we're going to go get one of those, and then we're going to come back, and we'll show you guys what we're going to do. Hey, Mason.
Yes, sir.
How awesome was that hunting trip?
Pretty awesome.
That was pretty awesome. My man Mason, well, really Devin too, they both shot their first deer. They got, what'd you get?
An axis doe.
Axis does. We were doing a meat hunt this year because we did a trophy hunt last year, as you guys saw. So they both got some decent axis doe, and I'm super proud of them.
Thanks.
They worked hard, they earned their shots, and they were accurate. So good job, guys.
Thanks.
Good memories. All right, back from the feed store.
Yep.
Look at that good axis right there. Mm-hmm.
Who's that one, Devin's?
That one's from yours. Devin's is underneath that.
Yep.
If you guys haven't had axis, that is my favorite type of deer meat. I don't think whitetail's all it's cracked up to be. I think it's good, but I don't think it's near as good as axis. So that's why we shot axis this year. Y'all let me know how y'all do it from where y'all are from. Everybody does it a little bit different. Down here in Texas, what we like to do is bleed our animals for about a week after we hunt. After we clean it, we quarter it, throw it in the ice chest like this. I like to crack one side open so the water can drain, tilt it with something, and then we just keep it packed on ice for 5 to 7 days, and then we'll either take it to a processor or we'll take care of it ourselves. Hey, y'all let me know in the comments below what you guys do. I'm interested to see if you guys bleed your deer or if you let them hang. I know some people that are in colder environments, I've heard of people just hanging them in their garage. You ever heard of that?
No.
They'll actually just hang them up from a hook in the garage because it's cold enough there that they can safely do that. And when it's dry though, I think it's more about aging the meat than it is like bleeding it out. But that's kind of what we do here in Texas. And I don't know if there's a better way to do it. That's just the way we've always been taught. So that's the way we're still doing it. It works. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. But I'd love to hear what you guys do. So y'all let me know down in the comments. Me and my man Devin, we're gonna add a nipple that's a little bit lower so the piglets can get to it, and hopefully they'll figure it out real easy. Behind us, we never really showed you guys that finished product. We got the new doors installed on the well house. So we haven't had a chance to paint yet because it was really windy the day that we finished it, and I've just been waiting on the weather to cooperate.
Yeah.
But we need to before that wood starts to rot because that's not treated.
Yeah.
I think it looks pretty good.
Yeah.
And it's a lot stronger than it was. It's just the well house. Hey, Kevin. What's up, buddy? What's up, dude? Hey, buddy. Hopefully I have the right pieces. We're going to cut this down and put a nipple somewhere around here so the piglets can reach it. They can almost reach this already, but I would like one to be just a little bit lower and real easy for them to get to. So I'm going to put one somewhere around here. What's the first thing you think we need to do?
Take off the old one.
What do you think we should do before that?
We get our tools.
Putting you on the spot. No, we already got our tools.
I don't know.
This is where I wish we had the Jeopardy music and I would just play that in the background. Think about it, bud. What are we about to do?
We unwire it.
We're gonna open a water line, right?
Yeah. Oh, we have to turn off.
To turn the water off. Good job, bud. We gotta turn the water off, and then we'll tear it apart and see if we got all the right pieces. I think we do. Yeah. Hey, Mama. Hi, beautiful.
Hi, handsome.
Hey, I've got to cut the water to the house because there's not a shutoff for this pig water.
Okay.
We never installed one.
Okay.
So are you good with that?
Yeah, I'll just have to restart the laundry and the dishes.
Sorry, babe.
That's okay.
All right, well, I love you.
I love you very much. Thank you for letting me know.
You're welcome.
I would have been freaking out like, oh, no.
I know. I was like, I better call her first.
Thank you, love.
You're welcome. Love you.
Love you.
Bye.
Bye.
What are y'all doing? You leave my bag alone. That's not for you. What you got, bud? You already finished mowing?
Yeah. Do you want me to mow over next to the trailer?
Anywhere.
It's kinda tall.
Anywhere it's tall, you can mow.
Okay.
Thank you, buddy. Hey, I don't want you eating plastic. No, sir. That's not good for you. You too. This is the little puzzle that we're trying to put together. This is the old one here. And we've got some nipples of different sizes that we're going to put a T in here so that there's a piglet nipple that's going to go in right here. And we couldn't find any piglet nipples in stock, so we just got the standard one. It's better than nothing for now, and I can order a smaller one online. These are for 50 pounds and bigger, and the little piglet nipples is just a little skinnier, and it's for 50 pounds and below. I think that the piglets could do just fine on this, but we will replace it with the right one. But for now, it gives us something to put in there, and it gives them access to water, and getting the plumbing done is the hard part. This can be swapped out pretty easily. Because it's kind of in an awkward area where we have it over there, it's kind of angled, her access is. So we got a little 45, and I don't know what we're gonna do just yet, but we're gonna do something like this and angle it back towards her just so it's a little easier access away from the fence. We have a yellow hot wire right up next to the fence, so we're gonna extend these out for both Kevin and her so that they don't have to get too close to it to drink. I think we've got our little contraption together. So this is gonna go on Sox's side of the fence in the birthing suite. Kevin's, we're extending his out so that the hot wire isn't as close to it as it was. We extended this out just a little bit for the piglets. That's gonna be right at about their height. And then this is gonna be angled better for Sox. That's our contraption.
Yep.
This looks like a reject from a plumbing class.
Yeah.
But hey, if it works, it works.
Yep.
We're just dry fitting it. All right, we got our water situated here. Now all we gotta do is see if the little ones can figure it out. I'm sure they will. All right. So we got our little contraption installed. As you guys can see, super simple. All we did was really add that nipple, and we kind of extended some out a little bit so it was a little bit easier to get to. This one right here,
is actually a little low for the piglets. They're a little bit higher than that, but they'll be able to reach it just fine. And then if they get any bigger, they'll be able to reach this one.
For a birthing suite, I think this is a really cool setup, and I think it's going to work out really well. Anywhere we have access to water, I like using these, because you don't have to worry about water getting dirty. It's mostly about cleanliness, but it's convenient too, because you don't have to worry about refilling something or if a float goes out, whatever. So what we do is when we come out and feed, we always check on the water. We just, all you got to do is come down here and it's working and you got water. Thanks for helping, bud.
You're welcome.
Devin here was a kind of a help. He helped a little. This guy can hold a chair down like nobody's business.
I'll be quiet.
I'm just kidding. He was a big help. Thank you, buddy. Well, I'd say that was a pretty productive day. What do you think, guys?
Yep.
We weren't trying to get a ton done today. I happened to be off work. It was the last day of my vacation for after the hunting trip. And this was just a little project I knew we could knock out today. So I'm pretty happy we got that done.
Yep.
Hope you guys watching this had a great Christmas. And by the time you watch this, it might be after New Year's. If so, hope it was great. Hope you guys were blessed and got to spend some good time with your family. Hope y'all remember Jesus. That's why we celebrate Christmas. What, buddy? Oh, look at that. Awesome. Good girl. Yeah, they're warming up. We got to come up with a name for her. Mm-hmm. Y'all help us come up with a name. We got a name.
Kavina.
Really? We have to name our breeder. So let's see what you guys come up with, if you guys have any ideas. Anyway, y'all be blessed. Thanks for watching the video. We love you guys, and y'all take care.